Good morning, TY BSc student. Today we are going to discuss on the chapter from paper 2nd from semester 1st, that is plant ecology and diversity. So the first chapter is the ecology. The word ecology is coming from the Greek word that is oikos and logos. The oikos means at the home. And logos means to study. So broadly speaking, ecology is nothing but the study of the organism on at their home or at their natural habitat. Ecology is nothing but the study of the plants or the animals or the microorganism, that is broadly speaking the study of the organism on their naturally occurring habitat or naturally occurring plant, that is place. So ecology is nothing but the study of the plants at their natural habitat. So ecology, according to the E.P. Odum, that is great ecologist, he defined the ecology is the study of the nature and the function of the organism, study of these all. So the ecology is, broadly speaking, ecology is nothing but the interrelationship in between biotic and abiotic components. Means when organism itself competes, means suppose there are the plants. These plants competes themselves, these plants competes with the other organisms and they competes with the other microorganisms. Means the interrelationship between these organisms themselves, that is known as the biotic component, and with the they gets interrelated to the non-biotic or non-living component, we can say that the abiotic component. So broadly speaking, that is the study of the interrelationship between biotic components and abiotic components is known as the ecology. These are the biotic as well as abiotic components. Study of these biotic components as well as abiotic component, it is known as the ecology. So what is ecosystem? That is systematically the study of these biotic as well as abiotic component is known as the ecosystem. So justly I told you that is ecology is nothing but the interrelationship of the biotic as well as abiotic components. So which are the biotic components and which are the abiotic components? First of all, the ecology is made up of the two components. Ecology have two components, that is the biotic component and abiotic component. Biotic component, as they have the they are living or they have the lives, so they have these biotic component are also known as living component. And abiotic component are known as non-living component. And togetherly, these biotic and abiotic component interrelated. It is known as the ecology, interrelationship in between biotic and abiotic component, it is known as the ecology. So, we are going to discuss one by one, that is, which are the biotic component. First of all, the biotic component. Biotic component means was the component those are living, they are known as the biotic component. So, they are living component. So, in these biotic components, which are there? That is, in these biotic components, there are the presence of plants, there are presence of animals, there are presence of the birds, there are presence of microorganism, there are the presence of the bacteria, there are presence of the number of fungi. These all together are known as the biotic component. For discussing this biotic component, that is, when we take the simple food chain, then we got the certain idea of the biotic components. These biotic components are again divided into three types or three subcomponents. First one is the producer. These are the subcomponents of biotica, or these are the biotic components. Producer. The second one is the consumer. And third one is the decomposers. These are the three biotic components. Producers, consumers, and decomposers. These are the sub or the parts or the these are the sub parts of the biotic components, or these are the following are the biotic components. So, biotic components are nothing but the, they are producers, consumers, and decomposers. So, togetherly they are known as the biotic components. Biotic component means they are living, they are divided into producers, consumers, and decomposers. These are the different types of the biotic component. So, when we take the simple food chain, suppose there is the grassland food chain is there, that is grass, grasshopper, then frog, then snake, and lastly the hawk. These are the, this one is the simple food chain, which is predator food chain. Predator in the sense that is the, when we passes from left hand to right hand side, the size of the consumer goes on increasing. So, they are known as the predator food chain. Sometimes what happens, that is, this food chain, when we starts from left hand side to the right hand side, this food chain is known as predator food chain. Predator means what? From left hand side to the right hand side, when we passes from left to right hand side, size of consumer goes on increasing. Such food chain is known as predator food chain. And when we observe the food chain in which the next consumer from left hand to the right hand side, size of next consumer goes on reducing, size is less, size is comparatively very less, it is known as the predator food chain. For example, there are the so many examples are there. That is, first one, suppose there is the tree. And on this tree, when there are the birds, and on these birds there are the bugs. It is known as the parasitic food chain, or it is known as the detritus food chain, parasitic food chain, where the from left hand side, from left to right hand side, continuously the size of next consumer goes on reducing. That is, size of tree is large, size of birds is comparatively less, and size of bugs. Bugs are the parasite on the body of the birds. These are the small insects which are present on the body of the birds. So they are bugs. They are comparatively very small. So this food chain, from left hand to the right hand side, when we goes from left to right hand side, the size goes on in reducing. So such food chain is detritus food chain, or it is known as parasitic food chain. One more example, that is, suppose there is the man is eating the plant, and on the body of man there are the presence of the lice. Lice are the parasite on the human beings. So this is very small food chain, but here the size goes on reducing. The parasite is small. Or when we take the example of mosquito, the man is that is, man have the parasite, that is female mosquito is there, Anopheles. So this Anopheles is the parasite on the human body. They touches to, or they sucks the blood from the human beings. This is the female mosquito. So this is the such food chain is the parasitic food chain or detritus food chain. So here the predator food chain is nothing but the food chain from left hand to the right hand side, when there is the continuous size of the consumer goes on reducing. So justly I told you, when we observe such food chain, justly I told you, that is the grass, grasshopper, then frog, then snake, and lastly hawk. These are the different components of the food chain. Here, when we passes from left to right hand side, then this food chain is made up of the trophic level. No doubt, it have the first trophic level, which is nothing but the T1. It have second trophic level, which is known as T2. It have third trophic level, T3. It have fourth trophic level, T4, and it have the fifth trophic level. No doubt, it goes on the continuously. That is, it depends, trophic number of trophic levels depends on the members of the food chain. How many members are there? Depends on that. There are the formation of such type of the trophic level is there. So any type of the food chain is made up of the trophic level. So when we take the example of this, or in biotic components, there are the producer, consumer, and decomposer. These all are the biotic components. So when we focus on the one by one, producer, the first one is the producer. So what is the meaning of producer? Name itself indicates that those organisms have the capacity to produce the food material. It is known as producer. What is producer? That is, organism, they have the capacity to produce the food material. It is, they are known as the producer. Producers are food producing organism. Which are those? That is, green plants which have the chlorophyll pigment in their leaves, or the green algae, that is the phytoplankton, we can say that. So green plants, green algae, those have the capacity to produce the food material because they have the chlorophyll pigment in their body. or tree have the chlorophyll pigment in their leaves. So they trap the solar energy, and as they trap the solar energy, this solar energy converts into the food energy in the form of carbohydrates. So such type of the organism, they have the capacity to produce the food material. So they are known as the producer. That is, they trap, they having the, they require the raw material, that is the carbon dioxide, with the water. They also require the water. In presence of, they require the sunlight, and in due to the presence of chlorophyll pigment, they can produce the food material, that is known as the carbohydrate. And lastly, the process or the product of the this process is releasing the oxygen. Means photosynthesis, when takes place, it releases the oxygen, and hence at the daytime it releases the oxygen by the process of photosynthesis. They trap the carbon dioxide in presence of water. They produces the carbohydrate, that is food material. They trap the solar energy, and due to the presence of chlorophyll pigment, they produce the food material, that is carbohydrate, and releasing the oxygen. So only the green plants have the capacity, only the algae have the capacity to produce the food material. Hence they are known as the producers. What are the producers? They have the capacity to produce the food material. So they are the producers, and example of these producers are tree or green algae or so on. Then next component, or the next component of this one, that is the biotic component, is consumer. Next component is the consumers. Which are the consumers? That is the producer. Just like I told you, producer have the capacity to produce the food material. They can produce the food material due to the presence of chlorophyll pigment. They trap the solar energy, convert this solar energy into the food energy. So producers are nutritionally autotrophic. They can produce their own food material. But these all consumers, they haven't the capacity to produce the food material because there is the absence of the chlorophyll pigment. So they cannot produce their own food material. So they all are consumers. They depends on the producer. So they are consumers. They are consumers. They eat the food material as a producer. Producer are eaten by the consumer. So they haven't the capacity to produce the food material. Consumers haven't the capacity. There is the absence of chlorophyll pigment. There is the lack of the chlorophyll pigment. So for the food material, they depends on the producers. Hence, they are known as the consumers. These consumers are again divides into the different categories. That is, the consumer which are the primary consumer. Then, secondary consumer and tertiary consumer. Primary consumer, secondary consumer, and third one, tertiary consumer. These are the different types of the consumer. So primary consumers means what? Those consumers directly consumes the producer. They directly consumes the producer, they are known as primary consumer. For example, these green plants itself, they are producers, that is grass. They are producers because they have the capacity to produce the food material. But when we passes from left to right hand side, from the grasshopper to the hawk, these all are consumers. Why? They haven't the capacity to produce the food material. They depends on the others for the food. So these all are nutritionally, there are the lack of the chlorophyll pigment. Hence, these all are nutritionally heterotrophic, and hence they depends on the producers. So here, when we observe this one grasshopper, they eats the green plants, they eats the grass. So they eats the herbaceous material. They take the vegetarian material. So they are known as herbivores. Primary consumers are herbivores. When we take the example of this one, this grasshopper only takes the green plants. They takes the vegetarian material. Hence, they are known as herbivores. Only grasshopper is the herbivores. Remaining frog to hawk, these all are carnivores. They are known as carnivores. Means they takes the flesh, they takes the non-vegetarian material. Hence, these are the frog to the snake, these all are the carnivores. They require the flesh, they require the non-vegetarian material. Hence, these all are the, these secondary consumers, tertiary consumers, these all are the non-vegetarian organism, hence they are known as carnivores. And sometimes, some organism, they takes the vegetarian material as well as non-vegetarian material. Means they can take the grass, they can take the vegetarian material as well as non-vegetarian material. For example, there is the example of this one, is the, that is, human beings is the unique example of this one. Human beings takes the both, that is the vegetarian material as well as the non-vegetarian material. Fox is there, fox is also the one example, that is they can take the vegetarian material as well as non-vegetarian material. So those organisms are known as the omnivores. Omnivores means what? They takes the vegetarian material as well as non-vegetarian material. So they are known as the omnivores. So these consumers are divided into the primary consumer, that is herbivores, secondary and tertiary consumers, that is known as the carnivores, or sometimes they works as a omnivores. Omnivores means what? They can takes the both type of the food materials, that is vegetarian as well as the non-vegetarian. So these are the different types of the organisms are there. That is, when we take the example, that is other example, suppose the grass is there, then green algae is there, trees are there, they are the producers. Consumers are there, that is the herbivores are, the cow is there, then rabbit is there, then donkey is there, then sheep are there, then that is buffalo is there. These all are the herbivores. They can take the green material. And the other consumers, they depends on the flesh. They are lion is there, tiger is there, wolf is there, then fox is there. So these are the next consumer, or we can say that lion, tiger, these all are the top consumers. They takes the food of food as a non-vegetarian of the tertiary consumers, or they takes the food material which is lion and tiger are the top consumers. So these are the different types of the consumers, those are the primary, secondary, tertiary. That is, primary means what? They takes the herb. Secondary means what? They takes the herbivorous organism. Suppose here frog. Frog is the grasshopper is the primary consumer. It takes the herbivorous material. Then frog takes the grasshopper. So frog itself is the secondary consumer. Why? It takes the this grasshopper. Snake is the tertiary consumer. It takes the frog, and the hawk is top consumer. So in this way, there are the different types of the category of the organisms. Only green plants have the capacity to produce the food material. So they are known as herbivores. They are known as the producers, and remaining are the consumers. Nutritionally, green plants are nutritionally autotrophic, whereas remaining are the nutritionally heterotrophic, because due to the lack of the chlorophyll pigment, they never produce their own food material. Okay, then next component is the abiotic component. Abiotic component are also known as non-living component. They are also known as non-living component. What is the meaning of this? They cannot produce their own food material. They haven't capacity to consume, but they are supporter for the producers, consumers, means they supports the living organisms. So they are known as the abiotic component. They are non-living, but they are required, they are essential for the growth of the all living components, supports for the living components. So there is the interrelationship between the biotic and abiotic components. So abiotic components are required, they are essential for the growth of the biotic components. These abiotic components are divided into three. They are the organic components. Then second one, inorganic component. And the third one is climatic factors. They are climatic factors. Third one, that is, abiotic components are organic component, they are inorganic component, and third one is the climatic factors. Then first of all, organic components. Organic components means what? The organic material. Those are essential for composition of the body of the organism, supporting of the organism. These are the lipid, proteins, and the different types of the lipids, proteins, and the carbohydrates. These are the organic components. They are lipid, protein, and the carbohydrates. Then inorganic components are, which are those? These are the carbon, hydrogen, then nitrogen, then sulfur. These are the different types of the inorganic components. And the climatic factors are there. Climatic factors are divided into, again, two categories. Climatic factors are divided into two category, that is as atmospheric factor and the next one is the edaphic factor. These are the abiotic component. Atmospheric factor means what? The organ, these components which are present in the atmosphere. That is, the CO2 is there, then carbon dioxide, that is oxygen is there, different types of the gases, those are present there. These gases are the atmospheric factor. They are also, there are the presence of the moisture, water content. Then the air is there, that is components of the air, different types of the components of the air. So this air is there, then sunlight is there. Air, sunlight, then temperature, then water moisture and precipitation of the water. These all are atmospheric factor. That is the factors which are essential. Air requires, then water requires, then moisture requires, then the temperature requires, sunlight requires. These are the atmospheric factor. Those are present in the climatic factor. And what edaphic factors includes, or what edaphic factors are? Edaphic factors are nothing but the topography. That is, particularly the soil and the structure of the soil, it is special. Topography means what? That is, the edaphic factor means so the soil and its topography, its nature. Soil is supportive. That is, any type of the area, in any area, this soil is very essential. So, soil is the edaphic factor, soil and topography. So, it includes inside this one. So, these are the different types of the biotic and abiotic components which are very essential. In case of the biotic components, just like I told you, the producers are there. Producers means what? They produce the food material. Consumers are there, they consume the producer and fulfill their need of the food. The food gets transferred from producers to the top consumer. That is it is totally chain migration of the food material from one tropic level to the next tropic level. It is known as the components or tropic level components of the food chain. But in this all, there is the next one is the decomposer in case of biotic component. What is decomposers? Decomposers are nothing but they degraded the body of the plants as well as animals or other living organism. They particularly, these decomposers are bacteria and fungi. So, what is the role of bacteria? They have the certain enzymes in their body, in the bacteria, and digestive enzymes are there. So, what they done, they that is bacteria attacks